everybody. So it's your favorite bearded lady here, and I'm going to show you today how to make your own big bushy beard with the use of crepe hair. It's really quick and really easy. The only thing is, it's a little bit itchy. But by the hairs on my chinny chin chin, I will show you how to remove it also, so stay tuned. So before we start, I'm just going to show you a few things that you are going to need. And that is, one, your crepe hair. I get all my crepe hair off the Grimace website, and it comes in all kinds of different shades and colours. So you've got plenty to choose from on there. I will also be using a makeup adhesive. I'm using Mastix glue for today. You could also use Pro Stick glue, or you could use Spirit gum. Just before you go ahead and put it all over your face, do make sure you have no allergies, so just run a quick little patch test on yourself. And then the final thing that you're going to need is a spatula, just for laying down the hair, or you can just use your scissors, it's up to you, but sometimes they can get a bit sticky and gross. So, but you will need scissors as well, just to trim the beard at the end. Okay, so first of all, just to show you how to separate the crepe hair from its plait, just basically kind of estimate the sort of length that you want to go for. So I'm going to go about here. Just hold this down with your fingers, your index and your thumb, and then with the other index and thumb, you just pull it away, and then you get little pieces like this. So to begin, first of all, we're going to take some of the makeup adhesive, and we're going to start from like the sideburn sort of area. So I'm just going to put a little bit on here, wait for that to kind of become a little bit tacky like eyelash glue. So just give that a few seconds, and then just grip your hair just at the tip like this, take your spatula, and just press the hair over the adhered area and just use your spatula just to stick it down. Hold that in place for just a couple of seconds, and then once that's done, you just layer all the way down. So there's your first bit that's attached. And if you wanted to do it for mustaches and things like that, it's just the same principle. So you could just literally just stick it over that area and then just trim it with the scissors, and then you've got a mustache. But since we are going for a full-on beard, we're going to go all the way with it. So just to show you again, I'm just going to lift the bit of hair up, follow on just underneath. So again, with the adhesive, just put a little bit on there. And this is the same process, and then just go all the way down to about here, and then we're going to stop. So I am going to speed up this part of the video just because it will take a while. But if we just get a little bit more hair. Just lift this hair out of the way. And again, just press it down with the spatula. So as I say, I'm just going to finish doing that up to about down here. So now I've got to this kind of stage. When you look at a beard, you will see that it kind of dips like this, like it's sort of like a curve. So just make sure you put a little bit just here as well, just to round the beard off. And then we're just going to go down into our chin. So again, just take a little bit more. If you do get kind of straggly bits coming up like this, just sort of fold it down a little bit and then just pinch it and then press it on. And I know it looks a mess at the moment, but as I say, you are going to trim it down at the end. So from here, I'm going to do the chin, and then just repeat this stage just on the other side so it all joins as one. We're going to do the top lip last because that is the most awkward, fiddly, annoying and gross part. So as I say, we're just going to go ahead, repeat everything else up to the chin and then just do the lip. So now we've got like the basis of the beard kind of there. We're just going to go ahead and do the top lip. So it's the same process yet again, but you just don't have to like layer it. Just do one nice thick application. It's going to be gross because it goes over your lip, obviously. So just bear with that for a moment until you get a chance to cut it. So. Again, just get your adhesive, start just at the corner where the beard ended just there. Okay, once again, take your hair. And just try and neatly shift it and press down. So as you can see, we've got to go all the way along yet, but just try not to talk and things till it's over, because otherwise you'll get them come into your mouth and it is gross. So I'm going to be quiet now and just finish the rest of this bit. Okay, so that's that done. I've decided to change my scissors because these are a bit sharper and better. So we're going to start with the lip first because it's absolutely repulsing. And we're just going to kind of lift the mask out of the way and expose your mouth. And then we're just going to start to trim. Be careful not to cut your lip, obviously, as well. Once it's exposed, it's just a case of just clearing up the area around. So I'm just going to keep going. Thank you. Okay, so that's good enough for me. And then it's just a case of shaping your beard. So you just do how you want to do it, basically. So I always start from here. And then I just literally just lop off as much as I want into the shape that I want. So you've just got to basically determine yourself whether you want quite a messy beard or if you want it quite neat. In which case, the best thing to do is just open up an image of the beard that you like and just try and shape it to the best of your ability going off that picture. Just kind of go over it as well and trim some away, because a lot of the time you can kind of get ones that are kind of reaching out like this and they're quite long, so just literally just trim that. And yeah, just carry on to how you want it. So that is a nice big bushy beard complete, and quite frankly I think I look bloody gorgeous. So what I'm going to do now is just show you how we will remove the beard. So to remove the beard, you just want a makeup adhesive remover. I am using Pro Clean because I think it's best, but any kind of oil based makeup remover will be just fine. So first of all, I'm just kind of going to grease up my fingers with it just a little bit, and I'm going to start on the underneath of my chin here, and in a circular motion just start to rub away the beard and the adhesive. As you can see, it's starting to lift. And it's just a case of literally perseverance and keep doing this. So we've got some chin back there, which is good. I mean, you can leave a mustache if you would like. And then just gently kind of tug it away as well. You can probably pull most of it off, to be fair, and then just remove the gross excess. So once you've done all this space, do the mustache last, because that is probably the most sensitive area, especially if you get like little baby hairs or like a bit of mustache hair or whatever. It can tend to hurt, so just be extra cautious and just gently start to lift away. And there we go, it's messed my foundation up everywhere, but at least we're nice and smooth. I'm just gonna literally clean the rest of my face up with a baby wipe. So that's it. So thank you everybody for watching my video. I hope it may have helped you. And if you would like to see more things like this, along with some grosser things and occasionally some pretty things as well, then please comment, rate and subscribe to my channel. That's it from me for now. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you later. Bye. Mwah.